In the problem scheduling with release times, we are given a set of n jobs. Each job I has a processing time ti, a release time ri, and a deadline di. To successfully schedule a job, it has to be scheduled between its release time and its deadline, and it has to run uninterrupted for ti units of time. The question is whether it is possible to schedule all n jobs on a single machine. Subset sum polynomial time cap reduces to this problem scheduling with release times. In subset sum, the input consists of n numbers W1 to Wn and a target number capital W. We can transform such an input into an input for scheduling with release times in such a way that it's possible to schedule all the jobs on a single machine between their release time and their deadline if and only if the answer to the subset sum instance is yes. We start by creating a job 0. And the release time of that job 0 is capital W, and the deadline of job 0 is capital W plus 1. The processing time of job 0 is 1. In any successful schedule that takes care of all of the jobs, job 0 also has to be scheduled, and it has to be scheduled between its release time and its deadline. But the release time of this job and the deadline of the job are only one time unit apart, and the processing time of the job is also one. So there really is only one way to schedule this job, and that is to start the job at time capital W, and then the job finishes at time capital W plus 1. In addition to this job 0, we also create one job for each number in the subset sum instance. So we create an additional n jobs. The processing time of job I is equal to wi. The release time of all of these jobs is 0, and the deadline of all of these jobs is 1 plus the sum over all the wj values. That means all of these jobs, if we want to schedule them successfully, have to be placed between 0 and 1 plus the sum over wj. We can successfully schedule all of these jobs if it's possible to select a subset of these jobs whose processing times adds up to exactly capital W, because then we would place that subset of jobs in the interval between 0 and capital W in an arbitrary order. And the remaining jobs could be placed in the interval between capital W plus 1 and 1 plus the sum over wj. This would fit exactly. So if the answer to the subset sum instance is yes, then the answer for our constructed scheduling with release times instance would be yes as well. The opposite is also true. If we have a solution for scheduling with release times, as we've discussed, job 0 has to be placed between time capital W and capital W plus 1. And so we can look at all the jobs that are scheduled before capital W. So look at that set of jobs. And we know that the sum of the processing times of that set of jobs has to be exactly capital W. Certainly it cannot be more, because then the jobs wouldn't fit. It also cannot be less, because then the remaining jobs would not fit into the interval between capital W plus 1 and 1 plus the sum over wj. And therefore, if we found a solution for scheduling with release times, we also found a solution for subset sum. We just take the numbers that correspond to the jobs that are placed in the first part of the interval.